Saddam Hussein's eldest sons, Uday and Qusay, knew their time was running out. They had disobeyed their father's advice of splitting up to prevent the Americans from hunting them down, and were now paying the price of their disobedience. Even so, the two brothers and their bodyguards were fighting like lions, cornered by the American 101st Division at the palatial Mosul villa. The U.S. troops tried to destroy the villa with launchers and artillery fire with little success, and Uday and Qusay barricaded themselves on the second floor, believing they were safe behind the bulletproof glass panels. However, they didn't count on the U.S. forces bringing the most lethal anti-tank missile ever developed to the forefront. Anti-tank missile. In the aftermath of World War II, the British, French, and American armies took inspiration from the Luftwaffe's Ruhrstahl X-4 wire-guided missile to develop a high-explosive anti-tank missile system. Testing and development drastically increased in the early 1960s, with the heavy assault weapon for the long-range time period, or HAW, concept. The West was now in the middle of the Cold War against the Soviet Union, and required a solution to get rid of Soviet armor at range if a communist invasion ever took place. The American MGM-51 Shillelagh missile and its capacity to be tracked with an infrared seeker became the focus of a weapon that could be guided straight into an objective and be adjusted mid-course. As such, the flare attached to the missile was switched for an infrared lamp, and the firing mechanism became a tube from which the missile could be launched to be adequately tracked. Programmer Harry Reid baptized the missile as the TOW, short for Tube-Launched, Optically Tracked, Wire-Guided Missile. Hello, Vietnam. The Army initially wanted to use the TOW in helicopters, but the requirement was quickly dropped. Three designs were eventually delivered by McDonnell, Martin, and Hughes, each with its own innovative features, but Hughes ultimately prevailed. After several setbacks, production began in 1969. TOW was then introduced to the armed forces in September of 1970, replacing the M40 recoilless rifle. The weapon became the longest range and heaviest anti-tank missile in the world. The system had several modules, including the launch tube, a folding tripod mount, a daylight tracker unit, a traversing unit with the trigger, a bridging clamp, and the launch tube sight. It was also equipped with a separate fire control system module and a battery pack. The basic TOW weighed 18.9 kilograms and had a length of 1.17 meters. The heat warhead weighed 3.9 kilograms and had a range of over 3 kilometers, with speeds that ranged from 200 to 300 meters per second. The first TOW units arrived in Vietnam in April of 1972 as part of the 1st Combat Aerial TOW Team. The team comprised technicians from Bell, Hughes, and Army Aviation and Missile Command to test the missile against enemy armor. On May 2nd, Huey helicopters successfully destroyed several North Vietnamese tanks near An Luc, employing TOW missiles. Weeks later, American and South Vietnamese soldiers destroyed over 25 T-54 tanks and PT-76 amphibious light tanks with TOW missiles, stationed across different fire bases. Much more enemy armor was destroyed by TOWs until the South fell in 1975. By then, the Army had more plans for the missile, making it even more devastating in the coming years. Tours of duty. The Army introduced the BGM-71C in 1976, featuring an improved shape for the warhead, and an extendable probe that triggered and improved the detonation distance. This TOW could penetrate up to 630 millimeters of armor. TOW 2 was introduced in 1983 and had a reusable launcher, a new missile guidance system, and a new sight. It was also equipped with a warhead that could penetrate 900 millimeters of armor, at ranges of up to 3.75 kilometers. During this period, TOWs were sold to Israel for the Lebanon War and the Iran-Iraq War. The Israelis distributed their anti-tank teams effectively, and by the end of the conflict, had destroyed over 30 Soviet T-72s with TOW missiles. The Iranians also used the TOW effectively during the fight against Iraq, destroying several enemy tanks and even Miel Mi-24 aircraft with it. The upgraded TOW saw action with the American forces during the 1991 Gulf War as part of Operation Desert Storm. They were mounted on M2 and M3 Bradleys and destroyed more enemy tanks than the colossal M1A1 Abrams. Hussein's two sons. During the Iraq War in 2003, the US Army and the CIA had been hunting down Saddam Hussein's two sons, Uday and Qusay, with little success. Qusay Hussein, 37, was the designated successor and led Iraq's elite Special Republican Guard military force. Uday Hussein, 39, was a publisher and commanded his father's Fedayeen militia. The population feared and despised both men for their cruelty and despotism, and the US believed that eliminating these high-value targets, or HVTs, would have a significant impact on the morale of the Iraqi armed forces. In June of 2003, Uday and Qusay established themselves in the palatial Mosul villa, disobeying their father's advice to split up for their own safety. Soon, an Iraqi informant that was close to the brothers and working for the CIA relayed the location of the HTVs to the Americans. At 10 a.m. on Tuesday, July 22nd, paratroopers from the 101st and elements of Task Force 20, comprising CIA operatives and Special Operations Forces, arrived at the residence with one objective in mind: to get rid of the Hussein brothers. The TOW's strike. The troops surrounded the Mosul villa with Humvees armed with 50-caliber machine guns, as well as Avenger and TOW missiles. The villa's occupants were then offered the chance to surrender, but they refused. At 10:10 a.m., the firefight broke out after members of the 101st attempted to break into the house. The Iraqi guards opened fire with AK-47s and wounded three American soldiers as they made their way to the second floor. 10 minutes later, more American troops arrived to offer support, and the soldiers unleashed their 50-caliber machine guns and rockets into the building. Kiowa helicopters were called in to target the building, but the Iraqi forces held firm inside. Then, at midday, the 101st tried to enter the building a second time. The men cleared the first floor, but the surviving Iraqis, including Uday and Qusay, hid behind a barricaded room with bulletproof glass. By then, the over 200 American personnel were tired of the enemy resistance, and the commander decided to call in a devastating strike of 10 TOW missiles fired from Humvees. A rain of fire demolished the structure, and with little more than rubble and debris left, the Americans finally reached the second floor and seized the building. The soldiers soon found the remains of the Hussein brothers and removed them. Some of the TOW missiles had directly penetrated the room and finished off the people inside. The mission was accomplished. Close Combat Missile System, Heavy. In the mid-2010s, the Army began preliminary research to develop a replacement for the more than 50-year-old TOW anti-tank missile. Despite its many upgrades, which have enhanced its lethality, the Army is finally ready to say goodbye to the legendary TOW. According to a report written by Todd South for the Army Times, the replacement for the TOW will be the Close Combat Missile System Heavy, or CCMSH. The Army expects this vehicle-mounted missile to have twice the distance of the TOW, with an estimated range of over 10,000 meters, or 6.21 miles. Additionally, the CCMSH will be drastically faster, reaching its intended target in less than a minute, making it lethal as a long-range weapon. However, this has not stopped the Army from envisioning this replacement for use at closer ranges. Mark Andrews, chief of the Close Capabilities Branch, told the Army Times that this new weapon would fulfill the same roles as the TOW, including destroying armor, fortifying positions, and counter-defilade. Andrews added, quote, "The new missile will need to reach those farther distances, but also be able to strike at shorter ranges. We want it armed early. We don't want to wait 1,000 or 2,000 meters for the missile to arm. We want to get it at less than 100 meters. Captain Ari Perel gave more details about the new missile stating that the army also wants it to use a command line of sight, fire, and forget, with lock 1 before and after launch. Peril noted the missile will also be able to target directly from a drone feed or a laser designator. The missile must also be able to defeat any active protection systems that can render it useless against hostile countermeasures. If everything proceeds as planned, the tow replacement will soon support Allied forces at the company or troop level in firefights against hostile armor. For the time being, the tow will continue its reign as the ultimate anti-tank missile until its replacement is delivered. As of 2022, more than 700,000 tow systems had been delivered to the US and its allies. And while the replacement arrives, the Army could extend the missile's life cycle beyond 2030. Thank you for watching our video. Please like and subscribe to our Dark Documentaries channels to find more exciting historical and military content about innovative weapon systems and the battles they're used in. And don't forget to hit the bell icon to be notified of our newest videos. Stay tuned.